Hello everyone, once again I welcome you all in the online lectures. Let us talk about a next chapter, that is colorimetry. In last lecture we discussed about one instrumental technique, that is called as a conductometry, and in that technique we discuss about what is conductance, what is resistance, what is equivalent conductance, what is specific conductance. Then we also discuss about the applications of this conductometry in the determination of conductance of the solution for strong electrolyte and weak electrolyte. Now in this lecture we will be discuss about a colorimetry. Colorimetry is the technique where interacting as photons, or we can say radiations, with a matter, and whatever changes in the matter will be observed, so that will be recorded as a spectrum. So what is meant by electromagnetic radiation? We know that this spectroscopy is one of the most useful and promising technique for the study of atomic as well as molecular structure, because in this technique we will be find out the atomic structure as well as a molecular structure for the various compounds, and therefore it is a one of the best useful technique. Here this technique is nothing but when the radiations or the electromagnetic radiation interact with matter, and whatever changes in the matter will be observed, and that will be gives a qualitative as well as quantitative nature of the substance. So these electromagnetic radiation, so these are nothing but during the interactions of these energy, when the radiation will be strike on the matter will be either absorb the radiation, or sometimes it will be emits the radiation. And the absorption and the emission of radiation is nothing but a characteristic property of the substance, right? So particular atom or particular molecule can be absorb a certain energy, or it will be absorbed at a particular wavelength of the radiation, and when it will be goes to excitation state, that means when the radiation will be interact with matter, the atom or molecule initially present at the ground state, it will be goes to excitation state, and excitation state is unstable state. It will be again comes to a ground state by emission of some light or some radiations, and these emitted light is again a characteristic property of the substance. So either will be measure the absorbed radiation, or either will measure the emitted radiation, so that gives a atomic as well as molecular structure of the compound. When the interaction of this energy either absorbed or emitted by the matter, so that will be gives a discrete manner, and that discrete amount of the radiation is called as a quanta, or it is also called as a spectrum, right? So when the electromagnetic radiation, it may be considered as a simple harmonic wave which is propagated from a source and traveling in a straight line, except when it is reflected or refracted. So what is electromagnetic radiation? Electromagnetic radiation are nothing but these are the simple harmonic waves. These are traveling through a source that will be propagated from the source and traveling in a straight line, and this straight line light or the radiation will be interact with, we can say, matter. So they will be traveling straight line, except so when there is a reflection or refraction, or when the light is reflected or refracted, either it will be traveling straight line. So what is electromagnetic radiation? Electromagnetic radiation is nothing but a simple harmonic wave. So this radiation will be associated with the properties of wave. We know that the electromagnetic radiation is nothing but it is the simple harmonic waves, and waves have some properties. Which are these properties? We know that the electromagnetic radiation, or nothing but it is a wave, that is wave will be, we can say, traveling from the source, so that is from the origin, and it will be traveling in a straight line from the x direction, right? That is the x direction. Then it will be goes in upward and again comes to downward. So whatever it will be goes to upward, same amount will be, it will be goes to, we can say, downward, right? So whatever the absorption or whatever the maxima will be observed in the waves, that is called as the amplitude. So this is the property of wave, that is called as amplitude. That is the, we can say, it is the maximum distance from the origin to the, we can say, y axis, that is amplitude. and the same amplitude will be observed at the negative x, that is minus a, right? And then it having a wavelength, it having a property, that is frequency, it having properties like wave number. So what is wavelength? Wavelength can be denoted by the symbol lambda. It is the distance between two successive maxima or two successive minima on an electromagnetic wave, that is called as a wavelength. So two successive maxima, that means when the wave will be goes to maximum amplitude, so from first node to the second node, that is the successive maxima, so this distance is called as a wavelength. Or similarly, from the minima, so same distance between two successive minima, this is called as a wavelength. So wavelength is nothing but it is the distance between two successive maxima or two successive minima on an electromagnetic wave, this is called as a wavelength. And it is generally expressed in terms of centimeter. Sometimes it can be measured in terms of meter, sometimes it can be measured in terms of nanometer, or it can be measured in terms of a angstrom units, right? So there are various units which can be used to measure the wavelength of light, and their relations can be expressed as, that is, when it will be measured in terms of micron, 1 micron is equal to 10 raised to minus 4 centimeter, or 1 micron is equal to 10 raised to minus 6 centimeter, or we can say 1 micron is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 nanometer. So this is the relation between micron, centimeter, meter and nanometer. Or 1 millimicron is equal to 10 raised to minus 7 centimeter. 1 micron and 1 millimicron, 1 millimicron is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 micron, and therefore 1 millimicron is equal to 10 raised to minus 7 centimeter, or it is a 10 angstrom, right? 10 angstrom. Or when the wavelength is expressed in terms of nanometer, what is the relation of nanometer with meter, centimeter and angstrom? 1 nanometer is equal to 10 raised to minus 9 meter, right? Nano, 10 raised to minus 9 meter, or it is 10 raised to minus 7 centimeter, or we can say it is a 10 angstrom units. 1 nanometer is equal to 10 angstrom units. Or 1 angstrom is equal to 10 raised to minus 8 centimeter, or 0.1 nanometer, or 10 raised to minus 10 meter. So this is the relation between various units which can use to measure the wavelength. Or generally we can say that 1 millimicron is equal to 1 nanometer is equal to 10 angstrom units. So this is the simple relation between various units which are used to measure the wavelength, that is 1 millimicron is equal to 1 nanometer is equal to 10 angstrom. So this is the one of the property of wave, that is wavelength. Second property is frequency. What is frequency? Frequency measure in terms of unit nu, the number of complete wavelength unit passing through a given point in a unit time is called as a frequency of radiation. That means when the waves passing through, when this wave passing through a source or in a straight line, then in a unit time how many complete wavelength are passed, that is called as a frequency. That is the number of complete wavelength units passing through a given point in a unit time. Unit time, this is called as a frequency, right? And frequency can be measured in terms of a nu, or it can be expressed in terms of a cycle per second or hertz. So this is the unit of frequency. So generally we can measure the frequency in terms of hertz, but sometimes it can be also measured as a cycle per second, or 1 hertz equal to 1 cycle per second. That is, there is a simple relation between cycle per second and 1 hertz. 1 hertz is equal to 1 cycle per second. Then the next property of wave is wave number. Wave number is called as a nu bar. Nu bar. So it is the number of waves per centimeter in vacuum. Per centimeter distance, number of waves are passing, this is called as a wave number. That is, it is a number of waves per centimeter in vacuum. That is, vacuum is again important. That means if the we can say medium change, wave number also changes. Therefore wave number is nothing but the number of waves per centimeter in vacuum, and therefore wave number is also called as a reciprocal of wavelength. It is also reciprocal of wavelength. Therefore nu bar is equal to 1 upon lambda. It can be measured in terms of a centimeter inverse, right? So whatever the unit which is used to measure the wavelength, suppose it is used in nanometer, it is nanometer inverse. Suppose it is measured in meter inverse, it is centimeter. But generally, your number can be expressed as a centimeter inverse. Therefore, it is a nu bar is equal to 1 upon lambda centimeter inverse. The unit of wave number is reciprocal of distance, that is centimeter inverse, for which the name Kesar has been assigned. Sometimes the unit in terms of centimeter inverse we can also use as a Kesar, and Kesar is abbreviated as a K. And what is K? 1 Kesar is equal to 1 centimeter inverse, right? So this is again a unit of wave number. Wave number is equal to 1 K is equal to 1 centimeter inverse, that is the number of waves per centimeter in vacuum. So this is again one more property. Then the relation between frequency, wave number and wavelength. So these are the some terminology which are used in waves, and therefore we have to see the relation between these frequency, wave number and wavelength. So frequencies may we know that frequency can be denoted by nu, wave number is nu bar, and wavelength as a lambda, right? So product of wavelength and frequency is equal to the velocity of the wave in medium. So what is velocity? Velocity is nothing but wavelength into frequency. That is, wavelength into frequency is equal to velocity. So as the velocity of light is represented by c, we know that the velocity of light, it can be expressed as c, and it is the maximum in vacuum, and it is the unit is 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter. 10 raised to 10 centimeter, 3 into 10 raised to 10 centimeter, or 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter. Therefore, velocity is equal to nu lambda. Nu lambda is velocity. So nu lambda is equal to c. C is velocity, is equal to 3 into 10 raised to 10 centimeter per second, or 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second. So this is relation between frequency, wavelength and velocity. Therefore, 1 upon lambda is equal to nu upon c, right? Nu upon c, because h nu is equal to c. Therefore, nu is multiplied here, it becomes divided here. Therefore, c upon lambda is equal to nu, right? Or lambda is equal to c upon nu, and therefore if we reciprocate this, that is 1 upon lambda is equal to nu upon c. So this is the relation. Then we know that wave number is equal to 1 upon lambda. Therefore we can replace this 1 upon lambda as a wave number. Therefore wave number is equal to nu upon c, or generally we can write relation as nu bar is equal to 1 upon lambda is equal to nu upon c. So that means if we know these terms, if the two values are known, we can find the third values, right? That is, c is equal to nu lambda, and from this relation we can find out the nu bar, that is wave number or frequency or velocity of light. Suppose we can solve one problem regarding to this, that is, calculate the frequency and wave number associated with the radiation of wavelength 400 millimicron. If the value is given, that is wavelength is given, we have to calculate the frequency and we have to calculate the wave number. We know that if the wavelength is given, we can calculate the wave number. Wave number is reciprocal of wavelength, right? So therefore, what is the value is given? Lambda is given, that is 400 millimicron, and 1 millimicron is equal to 10 raised to minus 7 centimeter. That relation we already seen. Therefore, lambda is equal to 400 millimicron. Then we can calculate the wave number. What is the wave number? Wave number is nothing but 1 upon lambda. Therefore, substitute the value of lambda, that is 1 upon 400 into 10 raised to minus 7 centimeter inverse. If we calculate this value, then we know the nu bar, that is wave number, is equal to 25,000 centimeter inverse, right? So this is simple relation. From that value we can find out the wave number. Wave number is expressed in terms of centimeter inverse, and the wavelength is given millimicron. Therefore, we have to convert this millimicron into centimeter. Therefore, lambda is equal to 400 into 10 raised to minus 7 centimeter, right? And therefore, nu bar is equal to 1 upon lambda. Therefore, 1 upon 10 raised 400 into 10 raised to minus 7, that is equal to 25,000 centimeter inverse. Now we can calculate frequency. What is the relation between frequency and wavelength? That is nu is equal to c upon lambda, or nu lambda is equal to c. Therefore, we can calculate frequency. Nu is equal to c upon lambda. C is given. C is the velocity of light. Velocity of light is 3 into 10 raised to 10 divided by lambda. Lambda is 400 into 10 raised to minus 7, and therefore the value nu is equal to 7.5 into 10 raised to 14 per second. So this is the frequency. Frequency expressed in terms of cycle per second or hertz, right? So it can be expressed as a 7.5 to 10 raised to 14 hertz, or 7.5 to 10 raised to 14 cycle per second, right? So this is the one of the simple problem. So same like if you have given any value, you can find out the alternative value. If you know the wavelength, you can calculate wave number, frequency. If you know the frequency, you can calculate wavelength, wave number, and so on, right? So friends, let us stop here. The remaining part will be discussed in next lecture. Thank you.